enthusiastically involved and willing to play for people like me, so I'm grateful that she's joining me tonight. The first piece that you just heard, My Darling Jim, is from an opera called Glory Denied by a composer named Tom Ciappullo, an American composer. And it's based off of the written work, Glory Denied, by Tom Philpott, who's an American journalist. And it describes the experience of Jim Thompson, who was the longest imprisoned American POW during the Vietnam War. So he was a POW in Vietnam for over 9 years. And the opera explores the effects not just on kind of the macro level of war, but also the effects on the people involved. And so the person singing that initial aria that I just sang was his wife Alice, writing a letter to him while he was away and before he was imprisoned. The next two pieces that we're gonna do are in French. They're by the Boulanger sisters. So Nadia Boulanger is a very famous 20th century composer and composition teacher, probably best known for being a teacher. Her younger sister, Lily, died at a young age, died at 24. And so the first piece is by the younger sister, Lily, and then the second piece is by the older sister, Nadia. Lily is famous for being the first woman to win the Prix de Rome, which was a significant composition prize. And then Nadia largely gave up her own composing to focus on teaching after Lily's death. So we're looking forward to presenting these two pairs by those sisters.
Thank you.
Axel. Her brother Felix Mendelssohn, for a long time, was the better known composer, but it's been exciting that in the last several years, perhaps the past decade, Fanny Hensel has really been coming into her own in terms of people being aware of how great her compositions are. Interestingly, she was composing at a time where a handful of women were getting some recognition for that kind of work. Clara Schumann, Pauline Viardot. However, Fanny Hensel was actually discouraged from composing by her family, including her brother. And on occasion, they published her songs as his just to get them out of the world. And so we're starting to know better which of those pieces those are. And even Felix actually acknowledged that at various points, saying, oh yeah, that song you like, that was actually by my sister. So this is a whole set of her songs. The poetry is really interesting. It's, I think, very emblematic of German Romantic poetry at that time. A lot of use of imagery from nature. And the last piece in particular is interesting because Brahms also set this poem, but Brahms and Fanny Hensel, other than two of the verses, chose different verses from the poetry to set. So you get a very different impression of the last piece in this set than you do from the Brahms, if you happen to know it.
Thank you. Oh.
couple of thank yous as we move into the next set of pieces. And we're really honored to be able to premiere slash preview more to come of a new cycle of songs for voice, clarinet, and piano commissioned from Dr. Griffin Candy, who is here tonight. So we have the composer with us. And I wanted to invite him to say a few words about these pieces and our process, and we're looking forward to that.
Hi everyone. Like Lily said, thank you so much for being here. We really appreciate you coming out tonight, tuning in online, whoever is out there. Lou and I know each other from what feels like way back. We went to grad school together, and we've kind of always been cooking up projects since then. And most recently, we started poking around at this idea probably about 4 or 5 years ago for a recital with Lily at Illinois State University, and ping pong things happened, and now we're kind of doing a soft open here. But these are five settings. We're going to do three of the five settings of poetry by a poet named Hannison Nash, who is a fairly well-known Jewish poet of her time, of the early 20th century, and is well-known specifically for her sort of titular poem of this cycle, which is called Blessed is the Match. And as we were kind of diving into her poetry, we found this really lovely kind of arc of a variety of different approaches that she took to poetry. Part of the reason why Hannah Sinesh's poetry is so sort of revered and beloved is that Hannah Sinesh was very, very young when World War II broke out, and she joined into the war as a paratrooper against the Nazis, and was eventually captured and imprisoned and then executed by the Nazis. And some of her last few poems that were recovered, she wrote while imprisoned, and Blessed is the Match is one of them. But she also has this sort of previous body of work before war happened at all, when she was sort of a teenager at home. And so we really wanted to explore the fullness of her as a human being. A lot of her poetry that is sort of the most trafficked is the ones about her struggle in the last sort of few months of her life. And so these first four poems really do not belie any of what you know happens to her at the hands of the Third Reich. They're poems of a teenager about figuring out how to be in love with somebody and figuring out how to be herself. And a lot of it is very boisterous and joyful and kind of teenage awkward and this kind of what you'd expect from teenage poetry. And I think we eventually do end with, it's not sort of in this little soft open, but we also set Blessed is the Match to sort of complete this rounded image of her. So we're hearing the first, third, and fourth songs in the cycle. I really want to thank Lily and Tuyen and Anne Durbin, they were all sort of the first team to make this commission happen. And I want to thank Dr. Mark Kramer for joining us and for being game for our little soft open for these cycles. So please.
Now, I'd love.
comments?